Dashera. Can anybody tell me a very interesting fact they know about Dashera? Just one fact. You know, it can be a why Dashera is celebrated. Anything. Just tell me one good fact about Dashera. Quickly. I'm not going to be unmuting you, so please type in the chat box. Ram killed Ravana. Okay. Ravan Vadh. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, okay. New facts. Rama comes back to Ayodhya. I don't think that's Dashera, sweetheart. Okay. Quickly. Does anybody have any other facts to say? Lakshmi Devi killed Mahishasur to ward off evil spirits. It is the last day of Navratri. Yes. So Navratri is a festival which is celebrated for all the goddesses. And Dashera marks the end of the Navratri. And it's the 10th day after the 9 nights. So that's just one interesting fact. Okay, great, good. I love the enthusiasm. Keep it up. We are going to be needing lots of it in the coming 1.5 hours. Now, I'll be showing you a video about some very interesting fun facts about Dashera. And we're also going to be, you know, getting to know about two reasons why we celebrate. Eyes on the screen, everyone. Quickly. Great. Fantastic.
Shakti was created by combining the powers of Brahma, Vishnu, and Mahesh. A battle waged between the demon and Shakti, and it ended on the 10th day when the goddess killed him. Dussehra is celebrated on the conclusion of the Durga Puja festival, which falls on the 10th day. According to the legend, goddess Durga visits her maker during Durga Puja and she goes back to her home on Dussehra. Her devotees immerse the idol of goddess Durga in water to bid farewell to her. The effigy of Rawana is the custom of celebration of this festival as it stands for killing all the evils of the soul, which are represented by the 10 heads of Rawana. Each of his heads stands for an evil. Kama stands for lust, Krodha for anger, Moha for attachment, Lobh for greed, Mada for pride, Swarth for selfishness, Matsara for jealousy, Ahankara for ego, Amanevta for lack of humanity, and Aneya for injustice. It is said that the first grand celebration of Dussehra took place at some time in the 17th century at the behest of the king of Mysore. The festival is not only celebrated in India but also in neighboring countries like Bangladesh and Nepal. It is also marked as a national holiday in Malaysia. Another interesting and unknown fact about Dussehra is that it marks the change of season, as the hot summer comes to an end, making way for cool and pleasant winter season. It also marks the time of harvesting the crops of Kharif and the new beginning to plant Rabi crop after Diwali. Dussehra comes from
Dussehra celebration. Once there lived an asura named Mahisha and Bhanubhala. Having performed severe penance for years, Lord Brahma appeared before him. He wished to be so powerful that he couldn't be killed by any god, man, or animal, and Lord Brahma complied. Marching into Swarglok, he drove out the gods and took over Lord Indra's throne. Realizing he would die only at the hands of a woman, the Trimurti lords together created the invincible woman, Durga. Shiva, Vishnu, Brahma, and Indra handed Durga the trident, Sudarshana Chakra, Kamandalam, and the Vajra. Mounting a fiery lion and with a deafening roar, she charged at Mahishasur and battled for a whole 9 days. By the 10th day, fed up, she flung her trident at him, and he dropped dead at her feet. And so Durga is known as Mahishasura Mardhini, the destroyer of Mahishasura. Commemorating the success of good over evil, we perform the Durga Puja every year.
You have to type in the chat box to what all you did not know and got to know today. Quickly type in the chat box. I'm giving you all 30 seconds. One new fact that you came, you know, you all understood and learned today by seeing his videos. Come on, guys, I'm waiting. Where's the enthusiasm? Name? Whose name? Your name? Whose name? It was a very nice video, I agree. They were very nice videos. Quickly tell me, guys. Quickly. I never knew that Durga Mata killed the Asuras. Victory of good over evil. Story of Mahishasur Mardini. But was not knowing about Mahishasur. Okay, great. So I'm glad you all got to know. And you all have to hang in with us till the end to have a fun, super fun, exciting, great time today. Now I'm going to invite Thea. Who's going to be singing a bhajan for us, which is related to Radha Rani. Now, Radha Rani is an energy of Krishna and so is Durga Devi. But Durga Devi is known as Mahamaya while Radha Rani is known as Yogmaya. After that, we'll have a solo skit by Duhan. So all of you have to watch. And you have to tell me how much you liked it. And after the end, you'll all have to say 3 Hari Bols for both of these kids. All right? I'm very excited. I'm also very excited. Good, good. Let's go. Keep going.
श्याम देखा Lakshmana, quickly go to Ravana before he dies. Ask him to share whatever knowledge he can. We should never forget that he is a big scholar.
Lord Ram's objective to come in this world was fulfilled.
That was lovely. Ruhan has brilliant acting skills. And Thea, she sung so well, so well, so well. I enjoyed a lot. Quickly in the chat box, type Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol to both of these. Quickly, quickly in the chat box, type Hari Bol, fantastic. Can you tell me who are the two brothers of Ravana? Y'all heard one in the skit. Can quickly, you know, type the names in the chat box. I'm reading. Lakshman was not Ravana's brother. Vibhishan and Kumkaran. Yes, that's correct. That's correct. That's a great answer. So Vibhishan and Kumkaran were Ravana's brothers. And you'll get to know more about them, you know, in the future, you know, in the events we have after this. So now I want to welcome Kavya. She'll be telling us what Dashera means to her. So I quickly want you all to, you know, be excited, you know, sit back and be ready and listen to her. And, you know, just tell me whether you agree with her or do you not. Welcome, Kavya. Please unmute yourself. Can you put her video on spotlight?
I can't unmute Kavya. Can you do that?
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. What Dashera means to me? Dashera means to me is eating mom-made delicacies, getting ready, and yes, extra rounds of charm. Well, I will tell you the significance of this festival, which you all must be knowing it. It comes after the 9-day-long festival of Garba. On this day, Goddess Durga killed the demon Mahishasur. Also, Lord Ram killed Ravan. On this festival, it is marked as the victory of good over evil. On this day, Ravan's effigy is burned with firecrackers. So, what are you doing? I'm going to say Dashera. You should go too. Happy Dashera. Thank you.
Thank you. That was wonderful. Dashera means an extra round of chanting for all of us. And I hope you kids are, you know, taking the holy name. So do you all agree with her? Let me know quickly. Do you all agree with Kavya? Yes, everybody agrees. Wow, great. That's fantastic. Okay, so I'm going to ask you all one question. What weapon did Lord Ram use to kill Ravana? What weapon? That weapon has a specific name. Okay, so you could tell me what name. Bow and arrow, yes, but no, it's called something. Somebody give the right answer. Yes, it's called the Brahmastra, and that's correct. Fantastic. You guys, I know so much. It's great to be, you know, in your company. So now I want to introduce Vishal Prabhuji, and he will be telling us what the 10 heads of Ravan represent. And over to you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna, kids. So now that you all know, we celebrate the Dasera and what the reason why we celebrate the Dasera. But what I want to know before that is quickly type in the next 30 seconds in the chat box, what are the qualities of Ravana that you all don't like? Quickly, 30 seconds. Just write the qualities of Ravana that you don't like. Weakness, anger, ego, very nice. Envy, pride. Excellent. Jealousy. Oh my goodness me. Evil. Very nice. So you kids are really amazing. So what we thought we'll do today is that we will discuss whether Ravana has really gone or not. And the reason why I say this is because Ravana was Ravana not because of the name. It was because of these very qualities that you all are typing in, right? These bad qualities made him Ravana. So if we don't want to be Ravana, or if we want Ravana to go away, because, you know, the truth is, in each one of us, there is that little bit of Ravana. And we have to ensure that we get that little bad quality out of us. Because only when all those bad qualities are out, then will Lord Ram come and sit into our hearts, right? And that is exactly what we want. We want Lord Ram in our hearts, and we want Ravana away from us. So let's take each quality one at a time, and how that quality is bad, and we can ensure that it doesn't come in us, or if it comes, how do we get it out? So the first quality that you see on your screen, and something that we all can associate with on a daily basis. Anger. Oh my God. Is it not something that we face every day? You know, it is just that feeling of venting out whenever a small need is not met. Yeah. That small need could be as small as, you know, maybe you're playing cricket and one team says out, the other says not out. And suddenly there is an argument. And that leads to a fight. Or it could be you're sitting at home and you're on your gadget and your parents come and tell you, look, too much of time spent on the gadget, you need to leave the gadget, it's bad for your eyes. And you get angry at your parents, right? So these are the qualities that come every day in our hearts. And we have, and though it is for our good that our parents have told us, but still we get angry. We have to ensure that anger is killed or suppressed, because anger kills us, right? So the first bad quality that we need to get out is anger. Okay. Now, 10 heads, 10 qualities. Anger is gone. Yes, it will go. The next is envy. Okay. Now, what is envy actually? You know, envy is that quality when our eyes pop out, when someone else has something that we don't have, you know, or they have some competence. So, for example, someone is a very good dancer, or someone is a very good singer, you know, and we land up comparing ourselves with him. That is where the problem happens. And that's when envy comes into our hearts. It's like comparing apples and oranges. Actually, we don't need to even compare. Okay, I'll tell you a short story to bring out this quality. So once there was an elephant and a cheetah. And the cheetah is the fastest animal. And he was mocking the elephant. Array, you know, you're so slow, you're so fat, this, that, I'm so fast. And elephant got offended. And he said, no, no, I also can be fast like you. I'm going to beat you. Let's have a race. Cheetah said, okay, anytime. Elephant said, no, give me 1 year to prepare. I'm going to prepare. And after that, we will have a race. Cheetah said, no problem. Come after a year. So that 1 year, elephant went jogging, went on a crash diet, did all the vigorous exercises. And then the day came when they had to perform the race. And ultimately, who do you think will win? Obviously, the cheetah won again. The problem was the elephant focused on the one quality of speed that he didn't have. Had he focused on the strength that he had, he wouldn't have that problem. So we have to ensure that we focus on our strengths, not on what the other person has. If we do that, we're going to be great. All right. So, and God has made each one of us very unique. So we don't have to really compare. We just don't have to compare. Okay. So anger, envy. Now, another quality, bad one that he had, Ravana had, was he was very happy at somebody else's loss. That means he had that jealousy in him. So if you look at the example of Pushpak Viman, his own cousin brother Kubera had it, but he didn't like that. And when he got it, he was very happy. You know, so this can happen even to us. So say, for example, someone, you know, in our building gets a very nice bicycle and then he has a fall or something. And somewhere inside us, we land up feeling happy or we feel good at that person's loss now or the damage that happened to the cycle. Is that right? No. That is that jealousy in us. And that is a terrible, terrible, terrible quality. So we need to guard against that quality. Jealousy, big no, big no. All right. So coming to the fourth bad quality was that of, see, it's a good quality, but it's also a bad quality. Ambition is a good quality, but being afford to do when it comes to ambition. So being ambitious, I want to come first in class. Great, be ambitious. But to copy for that, no. You know, if you cross the line of ethics or if you break the rules only to satisfy your ambition, that means Ravana is inside. So we have to make sure that that doesn't happen. All right. No rule breaking. We're going to be ambitious. We're going to work hard, but we're not going to be unethical. All right. Now coming to the next bad quality, that is your inability to, you know, take somebody else's, it's like how you get frustrated when somebody else provocates you. We have to have that control over our own life and our own mind. So it's like how you have a remote control. you know, with which you increase or decrease the volume of a television or whatever. So when we get frustrated or when we are easily provoked by someone else, we're giving our remote control to someone else. Why should we give the remote control of our life to someone else? Yeah. I'll give you another story for this. So once there were two friends and they were sitting in their garden and they were chatting. And when suddenly this one friend whose house it was, his neighbor came and he started saying all bad things to him. And he would regularly do this. All right. Saying all ill things. Arey, tumne galat gaadi park kiya hai, tum ye karta hai, wo karta hai, blah, 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 blah. And this man was quietly listening. And after that irritating neighbor went away, his friend asked him, what's wrong with you? This man is saying so much and you're like, relax, you're not even retaliating or saying something to him. Why? And this man coolly smiled and he told him, see, he removed 10,000 rupees from his pocket and he gave it to his friend. He said, take this 10,000. His friend said, no, I don't want. You keep it. He said, no, take. He said, no, I don't want. So ultimately, he held the money in his hand. And he said, look, I gave you the 10,000. You didn't take it. Right? So who is the 10,000 belonging to? His friend said, obviously you. He said, I do exactly the same. When somebody else gives you negatives, bad words, ill feelings, and if you don't accept it only, then it's going to stay with the other person. Yeah, it's not going to affect me at all. And when that friend heard it, he was extremely impressed. And he smiled and he said, I have learned this very good quality today. So we don't have to be frustrated and we have to tolerate provocations. Yes. Okay. Now, the next bad quality that Ravana had was he was always insecure and very possessive, you know. So when you're possessive and then you tend to become insecure because that question comes in your mind. What if? What if I lose this? What if that breaks? What if I don't get that? You know, that what if continuously keeps playing in your mind. And when that what if will keep playing, what is going to happen? You're just going to be insecure, and in anxiety all the time. That's exactly what Ravana had. He was constantly in anxiety of something or the other, no matter despite having so much, he was still in anxiety, right? So we have to get rid of this quality of being over-possessive. Now, the next bad quality that he had was lust. Now, what exactly is this? It's essentially when you want to acquire somebody else's prosperity. You know, it could be anything. Now, in Ravana's case, he had so many wives, right? Still, he wanted Ram's wife. And Ram had only one wife. And he had so many wives, but still, he wanted more and more and more and more. So when you want something that doesn't belong to you, yeah, anything, it's that feeling that I want it all. And it's only me and no one besides me. That is what lust is. And we have to ensure that we kill that. Yes. And the next of his qualities, which were terrible, was greed. Yes. And we all know how bad greed is. Greed is nothing but just wanting somebody else's resources. Uske paas ye hai, mujhe chahiye. Now, it could be a small thing. Like kids, when we are in school, somebody got a very nice compass box or a very nice bag. Oh, that greed comes in. I want it. Why? Why do we want what somebody else has? Right? We should learn to be satisfied with what we have. And if we don't cut greed then and there, then it will give rise to other things like envy and jealousy. So greed has to be controlled at the very basic. Jaise hi wo khayal aata hai, usko bolo, no, I don't want it. I'm happy with what I have. Now, the next bad quality that Mr. Ravan had was, of course, pride. I am Ravana, Triloki Swami, the most powerful, so on and so forth. He had that pride. And we all know pride comes before a fall. He was so proud that he didn't even ever think while he was taking the boon that a human being could kill him. He didn't even bother to include humans in that. And that's exactly the reason why Lord incarnated as a human, to to ensure that the evil Ravana was killed. So pride is something that leads to a fall, and we have to ensure that we don't have it. See, pride sometimes comes, na kids, with a position also that we have. So let's assume you're made the class monitor. Yeah, you become the monitor, you feel good, and you move around with your collar up. Yeah, I'm the class monitor. Yeah, but that's fine. You should be happy that you're a class monitor. But the moment you start using that and saying, hey, be quiet. Oh, I'll do this. Oh, you dare not do that to me. I'll complain. And when that attitude comes in, that is when you're getting proud of the powers that you have. And that is sure to lead to a fall. You need, when you get powers, you need to be humble that it's because of some good quality in you that God has given. All these qualities come only from God, right? If you're a good orator, singer, dancer, all this is coming from God. We only polish it with His help. So we have to ensure that pride doesn't get here, because otherwise fall is inevitable. Now, the last of his heads, the big bad head, was illusion. Now, what is illusion? Illusion is essentially when you don't realize how insignificant you are. You know, you're under this illusion, I am so and so, right? You think you're very big, you think you're very important. But if you look at this entire universe, kids, there are millions and millions and millions of living organisms. Like if you look around your house, all living beings inside your house, the crawling insects, the flying insects, you look outside, the birds, the n number of human beings, the n number of reptiles and animals that are there, we're so insignificant. And we think that we have no end. I said this means it must happen. I did that means it should happen. I. That I never ends. And that I is the eye of illusion. And the moment that illusion goes out, that's when. So essentially these 10 bad qualities, you know, once they get out and our hearts get clean, that's when Ram Rajya will set inside our heart. And that's exactly what we want. Now, I'll give you all one mantra, which I feel can work for all these 10 bad qualities. And that one simple mantra is called satisfaction. That's it. Satisfaction. If we have satisfaction, we're very content. We're always smiling and we're always happy. Because you are happy with what you have and what God has given you, and you enjoy all of that to the fullest. Yes, Ravan had everything. He didn't want to enjoy that. Duryodhan had everything, but he didn't want to enjoy that. He wanted to still trouble the Pandavas. So that once we have satisfaction with what I am, and I'm very happy the way I am, that's when these bad qualities will not enter. If they enter also, satisfaction will say, relax, mere paas ye hai. Relax, mujhe wo nahi chahiye. Relax, mujhe gussa nahi aayega. And that's when we will stay cool. And if we do our best in being satisfied and handling these 10 bad qualities, we can be rest assured that we do our best and Krishna will do the rest. So make sure, let's promise ourselves this Dasera, that we are going to do our best to ensure that these 10 bad heads of Ravan don't come inside us. And we leave the rest to Krishna and he will ensure that we stay good. All right. So Hare Krishna and have a wonderful Dasera. Let's burn the Ravan within us. Hari Bol. Take care. Over to you.
That was lovely. Thank you so much, Vishal Prabhuji. It was very beautiful. It's just the way you said it and the way it was displayed, it was immensely beautiful. I just loved it. And I'm sure the kids loved it too. Okay. You know, kids, it is said that satisfaction and happiness does not come from getting things you want, but it comes from appreciating what you already have. So that was the whole crux of what Prabhuji said. Moving on now, Hari Bol, everybody is, Prabhuji saying Hari Bol to you, and everybody loved it. Fantastic. great, great. I'm loving your enthusiasm, kids. Keep going. We still have lots of events coming up. So now we're going to have Amara, who is Vishal Prabhuji's daughter, talk on Dashera. After which, we will have a solo skit by Samvit. So now, you are showering so much love on all these people. You have to shower love on these two. So you're going to have lots of fun. It's going to be great. Pay attention. And over to you.
Hare Krishna, everyone. My name is Amara Diwan. And today, I'm going to talk about the Dashera. The Dashera, to me, signifies the victory of good over evil. Another name for the Dashera is Vijayadashmi. On this auspicious day, Lord Rama killed a 10-headed evil Ravana. To celebrate this, evil Ravana, Kumbhakaran and Meghnad are burnt all over India. At home, we celebrate the Dashera by calling friends and family over for lunch. Delicious chana, puri and halwa is made. I love the Dashera. Thank you. Hare Krishna, everyone. My name...
Jai Shri Ram! Wow! So cute! So great! We loved it. Now we have a live Toran making session. And as we had sent on WhatsApp, I hope all of you guys have all the materials ready. So now I'm going to be handing over to Narayan Mataji and Ruchira Mataji, who have been so kind enough to guide us through the whole process. So you're going to have fun making this Toran, and you can either put it at your altar or at the entrance of your house, at the entrance of your roof. You can do whatever you want with the Toran. Be as creative as possible. I'm watching all of you, so keep your videos on. Over to you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, everyone.
Hare Krishna. So,
happy Dashera to everyone. Happy Navratri. So it's a time, art time. Now Ruchi Mataji is going to teach a wonderful Toran for us. So be prepared. Let's start, Ruchi Mataji.
Yes, Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, children. So today we are going to make a wonderful Toran. So as I have asked you to keep this ready, 1 inch by 32 inch. So here also I have this strip of paper ready, and you have to just wrap your ribbon over it. This has nothing much to do. It's very simple. So I have made it ready. Just wrap the ribbon over this. This you can do a little later. After this, I'll teach you how to do these pieces which we are going to stick over here on the Toran. So these are the papers. I have asked you to collect these papers, 2 green and 3 of green and 3 of orange. So now we are going to first cut the green paper. So you can just like a fold like this. You can fold your paper like this, like a triangle from the top corner, and fold the extra paper. You need to remove this extra paper. So I hope people, you getting this, how this is the paper, the whole side paper. This is a standing paper. You have to keep it. And then you fold it from one end and bring it to the other end here. Now this is the extra paper which we need to remove it. So with the cutter, I'm going to cut this off. Yes. So now this is the triangle which I got. I have to cut this triangle as well. So with the help of the knife, cutting knife, I have chopped off this. Now we need to even further make those triangles more smaller by again folding it again, I have folded this triangle. Once I got this triangle, now I have folded this triangle. So I'm getting a smaller triangle. You're the same thing you can do with the other piece of paper like this. So with one sheet of paper, you will get four triangles, smaller triangles like this. So with one sheet of paper, you get four small triangles like this. So now let's start doing the leaves. This is the leaf which I'm going to teach you now. I hope I'm not going fast. I wish to, like, if you can do at least one piece along with me.
Kids, is anybody lagging behind? Do we want Matiji to wait? If you have not finished it, just type in the chat box and we can ask Matiji to wait. I can see so many people doing it. Gauri, I can see you doing it. I can see Vishakha. I can see Ahana. Everybody, show me your papers. Show me your craft. Okay, I can see Vrajpriya and Radhika.
Radhika.
Wow, lovely. Beautiful. We just wait for 30 seconds and then we can continue. We just give kids time to finish. Oh, great.
Yeah. Yes, I'll wait for another 30 seconds and slowly we'll proceed ahead.
So if anyone has a doubt, y'all can chat. Mataji will repeat.
Yes, surely. Now, keeping the bigger side, can you see here? In case if you start from this side, you will make a mistake. So keeping the longest side of the triangle, this is my longest side of the triangle. This is the valley fold and the mountain fold. This fan fold is also called the valley fold and the mountain fold. And today's this toren is in the form of origami. So this is called an origami toren, okay? Since we are just folding papers to get the shape, the required shape. So I'm making, as smaller this valley and the mountain can make, that would be really great. So this is the small, it's also called the fan fold. So the fan fold you can make as small as possible. So it will look very neat and tidy and even more artistic. So after I have folded this, you can see the entire stretch of the paper I have folded. Now we need to fold it from the center. It's just a single fold from the center. So we've got an image like a leaf. Now with the help of Fevicol, we need to glue it down. So with the help of a Fevicol, I am gluing this down. So this goes like this and a beautiful image of a leaf has been made. You can hold for 1 second so the thing gets stuck. So you can make a leaf like this. So the rest of the triangles also and the rest of the whole paper also you need to make the leaves. So like this, you will get about 12. So keep on making this. And by the time, I will also make one again with you.
So kids, anyone has any doubt?
Matiji, one kid has texted that they want you to just explain how you made the leaves again.
Yes, okay, leaves, okay.
Yes, yes, I'm showing you. Now, we had cut this paper. We had a rectangular paper like this, and we had cut it into a square piece of paper. After cutting that square piece, we had even cut it from here, the diagonal of the square. Both the diagonals of the square you need to cut. Once you cut the square diagonals of the square, you get smaller triangles like this. So once you get the smaller triangles, you need to make the fan fold, which is also called the valley fold and the mountain fold. So you can make a fan fold. Like how we used to make it in schools when we were young, like, you know. So in schools, we make this fan folds sometimes playing and sometimes for our school projects. Everyone must have made this fan fold in some part time of their life.
Mataji, can you cut the triangle and show once more? There are doubts coming how you have made the triangles.
Yes, yes. I will show you once more. I'll just get a sheet of paper and show you one second. This is suppose this is a square paper. Just a minute. If this is the square paper, right? This will be a bigger size in your case because I have just used up all my papers right now. So here I am just doing a cut. Like this. This cut here. And again I'm folding it. Again I'm folding it. And getting a cut here also. Here. So now my triangles are from the square piece of paper. I have got four triangles. From the square piece of paper, I have got four triangles like this. I hope this is clear.
Yes, kids, I hope this is clear.
Any more doubts?
No, Mataji, clear. Proceed.
So we'll start making the flowers now. Now, see, if you see this, this is the length of my paper. I'm folding it lengthwise like this. Fold on the longer side. This is a fold on the longer side of my paper. Then I need to cut it from the center. Now further one more fold from this paper. Again in the center. And I need to cut it here also. So from green paper, we got four leaves, four triangles, which we are converting into leaves. And here from one sheet of paper, we got four long strips like this. So this are going to be used as flowers. Again, same way, we need to make the fan fold. Make as small as possible. So the work looks really neat and beautiful. So you can even take the support of the table or the flat surface. Don't do it like on the hand like this because this will not give you the perfect finishing. Always use a flat surface for folding. Here, like this. So this is a fan fold. fan fold is like here. From here you press and you get a pleat. And again here the side. Again you can change the side. You get pleats, different small pleats you will get. So, okay, I think someone has written not knowing fan fold, is it?
So, children, everyone understanding? Mataji is asking, everyone is understanding?
Yes, you can cut with scissors. You can cut with scissors. I find it easy to cut with the knife, the cutting knife. So I cut with cutting knife. You can cut with scissor, whatever you are comfortable. As long as you do the same way and you get the same thing, it's absolutely fine. So once we do, this fold, you will get the fold like this. You see, you get the fold like this. Now, this is the most important part. I will just zoom in a bit so that you know exactly what I'm doing. We need to cut from one side, only from one side. A V. See, I have drawn a V over here. A V over here, and I'm going to cut on that line. I'm going to cut on that line. Here, like a V. So I have cut on this line. And once you open it, it shows like this. This is better. I hope it's not blurred now. So now we need to attach this on top of this. So for this, we will take a little more Fevicol. And apply it here on top. And the flower we need to apply here, keeping the V cut on the top. Keeping the V cut on the top. And you need to hold it for a minute or maybe at least 20 seconds, 20 to 30 seconds, which will ensure it is stuck properly. So you can just keep the V cut on top. And the leaf and the flower can be stuck like this. So you can see I have almost stuck this. I'm just holding for one more minute. And you can take some decoration and also stick it alongside on top. So you wow. get a flower with the leaf.
Wow, wonderful, Mataji. Isn't it, children? So I hope all are doing good. Yes, Gauri Mohan is saying it's wonderful, good.
Hare Krishna, children. Hare Krishna. I think we should slightly hurry up with the whole process. I hope you kids are going on with us. If you have any doubts, please reach out. Please just send a text on the chat box. and we would love to, you know, help you out.
Okay, this is not the white color. This is the glass. This is a glass piece. If you have a bead or any kind of decoration, you can use that. So, yes, you can draw also, or you can even cut a small piece of paper in the format of a flower and also stick it, or any kind of decoration like a bead or...
Great, this looks so beautiful. Children, come on, quickly hold up your own torans so we can all get a screenshot. And you'll just have to stick this on the on how Mataji is showing. And if you have not been able to, you know, go ahead with us, this video will be uploaded and sent in all WhatsApp groups as well. And after that, you'll have to promise us that you will send us your pictures of your toran, and it will also be uploaded on YouTube. So you'll have plenty of time and plenty of chances to make how many of a torans you want. And quickly put up your toran so we can all see what you've made.
Then you can stick it on the piece of paper, which was one, the cardboard paper. We had wrapped it with the satin ribbon.
Yes, somebody asked me what things you can use for decorating. You can use anything you want, anything you find. You can use a small, this glasses, you know, the small pieces of mirror and anything you all want.
Even if you don't have anything, you can color the pizza shells, and that also you can decorate.
Absolutely, absolutely. Fantastic, kids. Are you all ready for the next event we have? If you're ready, quickly give me a thumbs up in the chat box and we can go ahead. Thumbs up in the chat box, kids. Waiting, and this video will be uploaded on YouTube, so don't worry. This video will be uploaded on YouTube. So don't worry, you all will be able to watch it, and you'll have to send the pictures of your toran so we can all see. So
you can see now, see, after completing it will look like this. So you can hang it up. Yo, see, I have completed so much, so we can hang it up there.
Thank you so very much, both Narayani Mataji and Ruchira Mataji.
You.
It was lovely. It was lovely. It was done so well and so easily. So effortlessly.
Thank you.
So now, kids, we have Vaidehi. She'll be coming and tell us something very important. So we have to pay attention to what she's saying quickly. Wow, great, fantastic. Let's hear Vaidehi.
Hey Krishna, today is the auspicious day of Dashera. So, I am going to share a small story of Lord Ram in which he teaches us about forgiveness. When Ravana died, his brother Vibhishan went to him and spoke to him. You had so much of wealth. You had so many good qualities. Instead, you were also a Brahmin scholar. You had such a big kingdom. So, why did you fall into lust? Why did you steal Mother Sita? And he also told that I was your brother, even your friend, and even your well-wisher. So why didn't you listen to me? Now look what has happened. A whole dynasty is destroyed. Your family is also finished. And he kept weeping. Then Lord Ram came to him and told him that don't weep now. Stop crying. And now please fulfill your brother's last rites. Vibhishan had a hard time to follow his instructions. So, he told Lord Ram that how could you forgive Ravana
He separated Mother Sita from you. So how can you forgive him? And when we are fulfilling someone's last rites, that basically means to worship that person. So how can I do that? Then Lord Ram told him that the soul is all pure. The soul is all good. The only thing that is corrupt is the body and the mind, which is not separated. So there is no harm in fulfilling the rites of Ravana. Then Vibhishan understood that thing and he decided to fulfill his brother's final rites. In this, Lord Ram teaches us about forgiveness. He saw the disease, not the diseased person. He loved the person, but he hated the disease. So today, on this auspicious day of Dashera, we all should pray to Lord Ram to give a small drop of his forgiving quality into us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you. That was lovely. Now we have presentations by Gauri and Urvika. Let's quickly watch and then I have an extremely interesting surprise for you guys. Abhishek Bachchan? No, I don't think so. Okay, I'm waiting for the answers. Yes, the answer is Amitabh Bachchan. So he's gonna come and he's gonna tell you all a very special message. Let's hear what he has to say.
Namaskar, bachcho. Main Amitabh Bachchan. Aapko Dashere ki hardik shubhkamnaye deta. Dashera woh din hai jis din Durga Maa ne Mahishasur ka vadh kiya tha. वही दशहरा है जिस दिन प्रभु राम ने रावण का वध किया था। लेकिन हमारे मन में भी एक रावण है और उस रावण के कारण हम बहुत बुरे काम करते हैं, बुरा सोचते हैं। हम जो भी बुरा काम करते हैं, जो भी बुरा सोचते हैं, किसी के साथ बुरा बर्ताव करते हैं, वो सब हमारे मन में बसे हुए रावण के कारण है। जैसे प्रभु राम ने रावण को मार दिया था, वैसे हमको भी हमारे मन में रहने वाले रावण को मारना है। और इस मन में रहने वाले रावण को मारने का सबसे आसान तरीका है हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र का जप। मेरे साथ सब बच्चे बोलिए, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। तो चलिए सब लोग मिलके हरिनाम संकीर्तन करें और राम के नाम से हमारे मन में बसे हुए रावण को मार दें।
हरे कृष्णा। मैं अमिताभ बच्चन सब बच्चों को दशहरा की शुभकामनाएं देता हूं। आज हम एक प्रतियोगिता खेलेंगे, उसका नाम है कौन बनेगा रामरति। तो शुरू करते हैं ये प्रतियोगिता, कौन बनेगा रामरति। कंप्यूटर महाशय शुरू कर दिए। इस प्रतियोगिता में हम 10 प्रश्न पूछेंगे आपको और हमारे साथ 100 बच्चे के ऊपर है और हर प्रश्न के 4 जवाब होंगे, 4 ऑप्शंस। उस 4 ऑप्शंस में आपको सही जवाब सेलेक्ट करना होगा और आपके चैट बॉक्स में ए बी सी या डी टाइप करना होगा और हमारे जो कंप्यूटर महाशय है वो जो भी सही आंसर्स देंगे उनका नाम घोषित करेंगे और हमारे कंप्यूटर महाशय है गोपाल लीला प्रभु। तो प्रश्न के बाद जब मैं 4 ऑप्शंस आपको दिखाऊंगा सुनाऊंगा उसके बाद ही आपको आपका जवाब चैट बॉक्स के अंदर डालना है। अगर आपने उसके पहले डाला तो वो जवाब डिस्क्वालिफाई होगा। तो हम शुरू करते हैं कौन बनेगा रामरथी। पहला प्रश्न, पहला प्रश्न 5,000 ब्लेसिंग्स के लिए। सुग्रीव की पत्नी का नाम क्या था? What was the name of Sugriva's wife? The options are A. Tara, B. Sitara, C. Ruma, and D. Roma. आपके पास 60 सेकेंड है। आप ए बी सी या डी, आपकी सब लाइफ लाइन खत्म हो गई है। आप चैट बॉक्स में आपके आंसर्स टाइप करिए, ए तारा, बी सितारा, सी रोमा या डी रोमा। कंप्यूटर महाशय, कंप्यूटर महाशय किधर हो आप?
हरी बोल,
हरी बोल, हरी बोल।
अमिताभ बच्चन हरी बोल बोलिए, हरी बोल,
हरी बोल, हरी बोल। सॉरी सॉरी, हाँ।
और इसमें पहला ये बोलना है अपने को, रो 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 राधे श्याम, सी 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 सीताराम।
आप तो मुझे भंग बना दिया गोपाल लीला।
सी 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 सीताराम,
सी 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 सीताराम।
बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया
गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी। हमारे कमल महाशय बताइए सही आंसर क्या है?
सही आंसर है रूमा।
और कमल महाशय ये बताइए कि किन किन बच्चों ने सही जवाब दिया?
जैसे कि आपने रूल बताया था, जब तक
प्रश्न आता नहीं है स्क्रीन पे, आप प्रश्न पढ़ते नहीं है, चार ऑप्शंस आते नहीं है, तब तक आंसर देना नहीं है। बहुत जन ने पहले ही आंसर दे दिया था, पर आफ्टर फोर ऑप्शंस वेयर अपियर्ड ऑन द स्क्रीन, विजया और रघुवीर दे वेर द फर्स्ट वन टू गिव द आंसर। सो कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू बोथ ऑफ यू, विजया और रघुवीर जी, बहुत बढ़िया, बहुत अच्छा आपने आंसर दिया है। अगेन मेकिंग इट वेरी क्लियर, स्क्रीन पे आने के बाद, चार ऑप्शन आने के बाद, अमिताभ बच्चन जी ये मेरा रूल ये रूल बराबर है, और नहीं तो आप वापस रूल
है, ये रूल हमने बनाया है, और अफसोस कि इतने बच्चों को सही जवाब मालूम था फिर भी उन्होंने रूल के हिसाब से आंसर नहीं दिया। लेकिन हमें, हमारे पास और 9 प्रश्न है गोपाल जी, तो हम आगे बढ़े गोपाल नीला प्रभु जी।
हाँ जरूर, तो एक क्विकली अपन क्वेश्चन पूछेंगे इसमें, जो भी है आप डायरेक्टली आंसर दीजिए चैट बॉक्स में। क्विकली आई आस्क यू दिस क्वेश्चन, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, रामायण में दो तारा है, जो दो तारा है उसके बारे में बताइए, दो तारा, जल्दी क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स, दो तारा कौन है ये दो तारा, वालिस वाइफ, ओके, एनीथिंग एल्स, और एक है वालिस वाइफ, पुर्नेदु बराबर है, वैदेही, सानवी, आरुष करेक्ट, बट विच इज द सेकेंड तारा, विच इज द सेकेंड तारा, यस हरि दर्शन गॉट इट राइट, इट इज रूमा'स फादर, रूमा'स फादर एंड वालिस वाइफ, दीज आर द टू तारास। थैंक यू, ओवर टू यू अमिताभ बच्चन जी फॉर द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन।
इसके लिए बच्चों को क्या इनाम मिलेगा?
ब्लेसिंग्स, ढेर सारा ब्लेसिंग्स, 5,000 तो मिला हुआ है और ढेर सारा ब्लेसिंग्स मिलने वाला है सब डिवोटीज के पास से।
ओके, धन्यवाद, धन्यवाद गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी। हमारा दूसरा प्रश्न 10,000 ब्लेसिंग्स के लिए आपके स्क्रीन पे प्रस्तुत किया जाता है। विच वॉज द फर्स्ट डीमन टू बी किल्ड बाय लॉर्ड रामचंद्र? लॉर्ड रामचंद्र में पहला शैतान, पहला राक्षस कौन सा मारा था? ऑप्शंस है आपके, ए पटाका, बी मरीच, सी सुभाऊ, डी वाली। ए पटाका, बी मरीच, सी सुभाऊ और डी वाली। आपके पास सिर्फ 60 सेकेंड है। ध्यान दीजिए चैट बॉक्स में, देखिए किन किन बच्चों ने सही जवाब दिया। माशा है, बताइए सही जवाब
सही
सी या डी में से कौन सा है, बताइए।
बहुत जन ने आंसर ऑलरेडी दे चुके हैं, तो आंसर इज ए ताड़का, ताटका इज द करेक्ट आंसर। और जैसे मैं आपको वापस रूल बता दूं, चार ऑप्शन आने को आंसर्स देने हैं, 10 to 12 चिल्ड्रन ने पहले ही आंसर दे दिए थे तो उनके काउंट नहीं होगा। उसके बाद ईशान एंड निमाय चंद्र दे वर द फर्स्ट वन टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू बोथ ऑफ यू, ईशान और निमाय चंद्र, आपको ब्लेसिंग्स मिले हैं। और सबको, बहुत जन ने आंसर्स दिए थे, जैसे कि आद्या, आरुष, आभा, अदिति, अंजलि, बहुत जन ने आंसर्स दिए थे और सबके आंसर्स करेक्ट है, बट दीज वे द टू फर्स्ट वन, ईशान और निमाय चंद्र। क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन, द ओरल क्वेश्चन फॉर ऑल ऑफ यू इज, ओके, टेल मी द नेम्स, द सन्स ऑफ ताटका, द सन्स ऑफ ताटका, कम ऑन क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स। ऑलराइट, सानवी, पार्थ, गोविंदा, रघुवीर, प्रिया, वैदेही, लीशा, जगन्नाथ, त्रिडा, व्रज सुंदरी, राधिका, प्रिया, अमेजिंग, मीरा, Great. All of you have given the correct answer. The correct answer is Marich and Subahu. All of you together with me. Ra, 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 Raja Ram. You have to speak. Sitaram.
Sitaram.
All the children, come on. At your place. Ra, 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 Raja Ram. Sitaram. Hari Bol. Over to you, Amitabh Bachchan ji.
काफी समझदार है, काफी हुशियार है. प्रश्न 30, तीसरा प्रश्न. 15,000 ब्लेसिंग्स के लिए. रावणा किस में निपुण था? रावणा वाज आल्सो स्किल्ड इन ऑप्शन ए पेंटर, ऑप्शन बी डांसर, ऑप्शन सी स्कल्प्टर, ऑप्शन डी म्यूजिशियन. योर टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ. देखते हैं आप कितने अच्छी तरह रावण को पहचान सकते हो. ए पेंटर, बी डांसर, सी स्कल्प्टर, डी म्यूजिशियन. कंप्यूटर महाशय बताइए.
द करेक्ट आंसर ऑलमोस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू, many of them they have given, is the answer is D, musician. Or the correct one, the first one who mentioned was Shilpa and Shriji. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you so much for giving the right answer.
Prabhuji, we move to the fourth question. Which of the following books on Ramayana does not exist? Isme se kaun si pustak Ramayana pe aadharit nahi hai? ऑप्शन ए कंब रामायण, ऑप्शन बी तुलसी रामायण, ऑप्शन सी वाल्मीकि रामायण एंड ऑप्शन डी तत्व रामायण. योर टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ. ए कंब रामायण, बी तुलसी रामायण, सी वाल्मीकि रामायण, डी तत्व रामायण. कमेडम आशय, मैडम आशय, आपको क्या लगता है सही जवाब क्या है? ए बी सी या डी?
मैंने ज्यादा पढ़ाई नहीं किया है अमिताभ बच्चन जी, तो इसीलिए मैं आंसर दे नहीं पाऊंगा. पर मुझे 200% गारंटी है सब ये बच्चों ने, ये कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस बच्चे हैं, उनको सब पता है. आपको सही जवाब थोड़ी देर में 10 सेकंड में आपको मिल जाएगा.
ये आपकी आपकी ह्यूमिलिटी मुझे बहुत पसंद आती है गोपाली लखोल जी. शायद मैं आपकी जैसा थोड़ा और हम्बल बन सकता हूं.
ओके, द करेक्ट आंसर इज तत्व. मुझे दिख नहीं रहा है ये लास्ट ऑप्शन. डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर.
एंड
यस, एंड द आंसर वर गिवन बाय सानवी एंड श्रीरंग. कांग्रेचुलेशंस टू बोथ ऑफ यू.
थैंक यू वेरी मच. द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर 20,000 ब्लेसिंग्स. द हु वाज द वाइफ ऑफ शत्रुघ्न, राम्स ब्रदर शत्रुघ्न. शत्रुघ्न जी की धर्म पत्नी का नाम बताइए. ऑप्शन श्रुतकीर्ति, श्रुतनिष्ठा, श्रुतवेद्या या डी शर्मिष्ठा. शर्मिष्ठा. आपका टाइम शुरू होता है अब. श्रुतकीर्ति, श्रुतनिष्ठा, श्रुतवेद्या, शर्मिष्ठा. माशा, आपको क्या लगता है इसका सही जवाब क्या हो सकता है? दस सेकेंड बाकी. तो अमन माशाई गोमाल लीला प्रभु जी आपको जवाब आ गए आपके स्क्रीन पे।
ईशान और साहिब ये दो बच्चे हैं, उन्होंने सही जवाब दिया था एकदम स्टार्टिंग में, तो कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस टू बोथ ऑफ यू। आप मुझे क्वेश्चन पूछ रहे थे पर मैं थोड़ा चेक कर रहा था जिन्होंने फर्स्ट आंसर दिया है। थैंक यू।
ओके, सो व्हाट इज द राइट आंसर गोपाल जी लखन जी?
सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज श्रुतकीर्ति। श्रुतकीर्ति इज द करेक्ट आंसर।
ओके एंड थैंक यू। We move to the next question. Which was the mountain which Lakshman ji carried, which Hanuman ji carried to heal Lakshman ji? Hanuman ji ne kaun sa parvat Lakshman ji ke liye leke aaye the? Option A, Kamgiri. Option B, Dronagiri. Option C, Sayadri. Or option D, शेषाद्र। आपका वक्त शुरू होता है अब। कमेंट महाशय बताइए किन किन बच्चों ने सही जवाब दिया?
पूर्णे दू और वैदेही ये दो बच्चे थे, उन्होंने फर्स्ट आंसर दिया है और द करेक्ट आंसर इज द्रोणागिरी। क्विकली मैं आपको बोलना चाहता हूं, हनुमान जी द्रोणागिरी पर्वत उठा के लाए क्योंकि उनको एक बूटी मिल नहीं रही थी जिनका नाम था संजीवनी बूटी, जिससे वो लक्ष्मण जी और राम जी को हील करने वाले थे और इसीलिए वो मिला नहीं, इसीलिए पूरा पर्वत ही उन्होंने उठा के लेके आए द्रोणागिरी। थैंक यू। ओवर टू यू अमिताभ बच्चन जी।
गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी थैंक यू। द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर 50,000 ब्लेसिंग्स, रावणा की मां का नाम क्या था? नेम ऑफ रावणास मदर वाज रिजाता, बी जय ललिता, सी मायावती, डी कैटकुशी, ए सुजाता, बी जय ललिता, सी मायावती और डी कैटकुशी। आपका वक्त शुरू होता है अब। हमने सुना है कि इस्कॉन में बच्चे बहुत होशियार और उनको हमारे संस्कृति के बारे में काफी कुछ ज्ञान है। मुझे काफी कुछ सीखना पड़ेगा आपके बच्चों से।
अमिताभ बच्चन जी मैं आपको रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा, आप प्लीज ये संडे फन स्कूल हमारा होता है हर रविवार, तो प्लीज आप एनरोल कीजिए, तो उसमें बहुत सारे अच्छे टीचर्स हैं, वो अच्छे से तरह आपको कल्चर देंगे और बहुत सारे आप बच्चों से भी अच्छा संघ से आप बहुत कुछ सीख सकते हो उनके पास से।
जब हम चौपाटी में आएंगे भेलपुरी खाने को तो हम आपके हाँ, मंदिर भी आएंगे।
बहुत बढ़िया।
तो आंसर बताइए।
तो आंसर है, आंसर करेक्ट आंसर इज कैकशी और हर्षिता और नमिश, ये दो बच्चे ने पहली एकदम फर्स्ट उन्होंने आंसर दिया है। क्विकली चैट बॉक्स में मुझे बताइए कौन है रावण के फादर का नाम, रावण के फादर का नाम क्विकली ऑन द चैट बॉक्स। हर्षिता गॉट इट राइट, हर्षिता, हेमांगी, रघुवीर, ग्रेट, ऑल राइट, वैदेही, श्रीरंग, श्रीता, पार्थ, परफेक्ट। ओवर टू यू अमिताभ बच्चन जी।
बढ़िया बढ़िया बहुत बढ़िया बहुत बढ़िया।
विश और उनका नाम है विश्व श्रव, विश्वश्रव है रावण के फादर का नाम.
थैंक यू. विच वॉज अ सिटी फाउंडेड बाय द सन ऑफ लॉर्ड राम लव. लव ने कौन सी जगह की स्थापना की थी, कौन सी सिटी की स्थापना की थी? लाहौर ए, बी लुधियाना, सी लद्दाख, डी लखनऊ. द टाइम स्टार्ट्स नाउ. कमेंट महाशय ध्यान से देखिए. बच्चे लोग काफी इंटरेस्ट से देख रहे हैं, काफी गंभीरता से सोच रहे हैं और काफी उत्साह से जवाब दे रहे हैं. मोगेम्बो खुश हुआ, सॉरी अमिताभ बच्चन खुश हुआ.
अमिताभ बच्चन जी आपको पता है इसका आंसर?
मैं एक्चुअली ये ऐसा एक प्रश्न है जो मुझे इसका आंसर पता है बिकॉज मैं इस जगह गया हूँ.
ओ बहुत बढ़िया.
हाँ जी, तो आप मुझे टेस्ट कर रहे हो गोपाल जीरा पहुंची.
मैं सोच रहा था कि आपको कुछ पता है क्या नहीं, क्योंकि आप ही बोल रहे थे मुझे कुछ ज्यादा पता नहीं है, मुझे ये बच्चों से सीखना चाहिए, तो मैं भी थोड़ा टेस्ट कर रहा था आपसे.
मैं पास हो गया गोपाल लीला पौजी.
बहुत एकदम 200 मार्क्स से पास हो गया.
धन्यवाद धन्यवाद गोपाल लीला पौजी धन्यवाद.
तो आपको ये आंसर देना अभी, करेक्ट आंसर क्या है?
ओके सो द करेक्ट आंसर इज, हाँ वो है हिंदुस्तान में लेकिन हमारे पड़ोसी देश में है वो, और उसका नाम है ए लाहौर.
बहुत बढ़िया बहुत बढ़िया. तो इसके विजय, इसके विजेता है रुजुला और पार्थ. रुजुला और पार्थ बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, आपने बहुत बढ़िया से आंसर दिया है. और क्विकली आपको और एक पूछना चाहता हूं, इसके पहले का नाम क्या था, किसको पता है लाहौर के पहले का नाम क्या था?
ये मुझे नहीं पता.
लाहौर के पहले
इसके इसका इसका प्रश्न का इसका जवाब मुझे पता नहीं.
नो प्रॉब्लम. यस समवन अंजलि गॉट इट राइट. यस लवपुरी, लवपुरी ये बराबर आंसर है. लवपुरी ये पहला था लाहौर के पहले, लवपुरी इसको जाना जाता था. ओवर टू यू अमिताभ बच्चन जी. लास्ट टू क्वेश्चंस.
मुझे वापस से भेलपुरी की याद आ गई, आपने लवपुरी सुनाया तो. ओके नौवा क्वेश्चन आपके स्क्रीन पे आ रहा है. भरत जी की पत्नी का नाम किस तालाब से मिलता जुलता है और वो तालाब किस जगह में है? द नेम ऑफ भरत वाइफ मैचेस अ रिवर इन त्रिंबकेश्वर, बी गोवा, सी हरिद्वार, डी बद्रीनाथ. भरत जी की वाइफ का नाम मैचेस विद विच रिवर? ए त्रिंबकेश्वर, बी गोवा, सी हरिद्वार, डी बद्रीनाथ. गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी इस बार मैं आपको पूछता हूं, आपको इसका जवाब पता है?
हाँ इसका मुझे पता है, क्योंकि ये मैंने पहले ही चालू होने के पहले ही मुझे कंप्यूटर ये बनाया गया है, कंप्यूटर महाशय बनाया गया है, तो मैंने पहले ही जानकारी ली थी गूगल से क्या आंसर इसका करेक्ट आंसर है. तो मैं तो कभी मैं इस जगह पे
तो
मैं इस जगह पे गया हूँ पर मुझे पता नहीं था.
अच्छा
भरत जी के
भरत जी की वाइफ का नाम बताइए.
मांडवी, मांडवी ये आंसर है भरत जी के वाइफ का नाम, पर बहुत जन ने ये आंसर गलत किया है, मुझे दिख ही नहीं रहा है कौन इसमें फर्स्ट आया, बिकॉज मैक्सिमम आंसर वेयर अराउंड सी एंड डी. करेक्ट आंसर इज गोवा, दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. गोवा में ये स्थित है मांडवी रिवर, और इसीलिए दिस इज द आंसर, द करेक्ट आंसर इज मांडवी.
बच्चों आप लोग को गोवा और जाना चाहिए. मैंने एक पिक्चर में एक्टिंग की थी, उसका नाम था बॉम्बे टू गोवा, शायद आप लोग ने वो पिक्चर देखी होगी. तो बहुत ही अच्छी जगह है गोवा.
बहुत बढ़िया. सॉरी अमिताभ बच्चन जी.
हाँ जी
नहीं नहीं सॉरी, आप कंटिन्यू कीजिए, कंटिन्यू कीजिए।
हाँ जी, तो मैंने एक पिक्चर में एक्टिंग की थी, उसका नाम था बॉम्बे टू गोवा। गोवा काफी अच्छी जगह है आराम करने के लिए, और मैंने सुना है कि उधर इस्कॉन के भी भक्त रहते हैं, तो कृपा करके थोड़ा गोवा भी जाइए और थोड़ा आराम करिए,
थोड़ा मंदिर भी घूमिए।
आखिरी प्रश्न, किंग दशरथ मदर, किंग दशरथ मदर इंदुमती was from the following place in Maharashtra? King Dashrath ki mata Indumati wo Maharashtra ke kis bhagya se thi, kis jagah se thi? Aur aapke char options aapke screen pe prastut kiya jata hai. Option A Boldhana, option B Nagpur, option C Vidarbha, option D नासिक। गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी, आप मानोगे कि ये प्रश्न आसान नहीं, ये काफी कठिन है, और अगर आपके बच्चों ने ये आंसर दे दिया तो मैं समझूंगा कि इस्कॉन काफी अच्छा काम कर रहा है बच्चों को आध्यात्मिक बनाने में। ये मैं आपको चुनौती देता हूं कि अगर आपके बच्चों ने यह जवाब दे दिया, मेरी तरफ से एक बहुत बड़ा सल्यूट इस्कॉन को। आपको क्या लगता है गोपाल लीला प्रभु जी, ये जवाब दे पाएंगे?
बहुत बच्चों ने करेक्ट आंसर दिया है ऑलरेडी।
ये खुशी की बात है, बिना कोई लाइफलाइन,
बिना कोई लाइफलाइन,
और इतना तुरंत,
एकदम तुरंत।
अगर मेरा बच्चा अभिषेक बच्चन अगर इस्कॉन में जाता था, मेरे घर के सामने है इस्कॉन, तो आज शायद वो काफी उसमें और भी काफी अच्छे गुण पैदा होते थे। तो सही जवाब, इसका सही जवाब बताइए कंप्यूटर मास्टर।
इसका सही जवाब है विदर्भ, सी विदर्भ। और इस प्रश्न के विजेता है फियोनी और नौरतम पाल, ये दोनों बच्चों ने सही जवाब दिया है विदर्भ, फियोनी और नौरतम गोपाल। क्विकली मुझे ये पूछना है इसके बारे में, और किसने, कौन सा, कौन से एक व्यक्ति है जो सेम प्लेस से बिलोंग करते हैं? मैं एक क्लू दूंगा आपको, ये कृष्णा की वाइफ है, तो कोई बोल सकता है यस हेमांगी, यू गॉट इट राइट। आरुष, जगन्नाथ, हर्षिता, कार्तिक, बढ़िया, बहुत बढ़िया। रुक्मिनी आंसर है, ओ टू यू अमिताभ बच्चन जी।
धन्यवाद, थैंक यू, बहुत अच्छा लगा आप लोग के साथ दशहरा मनाने में। और अभी हम इस कार्यक्रम को, इस प्रतियोगिता को, इस त्योहार को समाप्त करेंगे एक सुंदर से गाने से, और जैसा ये गाना बजेगा हम सब उठ के भगवान का नाम लेके नाचेंगे। तो सब लोग उठ जाइए और साथ में हम नाचेंगे ये सुंदर गीत पे।
अमिताभ बच्चन जी, आपको नाचना आता है ना?
हाँ जी।
हाँ बहुत बढ़िया, आपका जो स्टेप है वो करना, जो आपका यूजुअल स्टेप है।
हाँ जी, मैं वो करूंगा।
ठीक है ठीक है। हाँ,
कौन सी पिक्चर का गाना, कौन सी पिक्चर की गाना पे आपने मेरा डांस देखा है?
जो लेटेस्ट है भूतनाथ के ऊपर।
अच्छा, आप करिए मैं देखूंगा।
उसमें थोड़ा डांस किया आपने।
हाँ,
वो मैंने देखा है।
हाँ,
तो वैसा ही स्टेप करना।
हाँ जी, आप मुझे बताइए, मैं थोड़ा भूल गया हूँ, मेरी उम्र थोड़ी।
राम जय राजा राम, राम राम जय सीता राम, राम राम जय राजा राम, राम राम जय सीता राम, राम राम जय राजा राम, राम राम जय सीता राम, राम राम जय राजा राम, राम राम जय सीता राम, राम राम जय राजा।
जय श्री राम, जय श्री राम।